94.7 QDR. Hey, it's Heather Davis. It's another edition of Fursday, and today I've got Molly and Mary with the Animal Protection Society of Durham. How's it going?
That's great. Great.
Excellent. And
thanks for having us, Heather.
I see Oliver. Look at that face. What a cutie pie.
He's quite enthralled with you. I think he might want to come home with you.
Sure, Shadow and Lucy would love him. So tell us a little bit about him.
Well, Oliver is my foster dog, and he has an interesting story. He came into the shelter, and he was terrified. First of all, he does not like a lot of noise. He's very shy and retiring, and he also thought the floors in the animal shelter were exceptionally scary.
Oh.
In fact, it's like, you know, that whole thing, floors are lava. Oliver thought they were lava. And I tell you, Heather, I've been a volunteer at this shelter since 2012, and I'm so impressed with how the staff goes above and beyond for dogs. Because this was a dog that was so scared. One of the dog techs told me they never saw him lie down in his bed. He had a bed, but it almost looked like 24/7 was just, you know, standing there like, how did I get in this mess?
Oh, baby.
They weren't even sure if they could get him out of the kennel to do a behavior evaluation. They actually had to put some towels down on the floor. The behavior manager was telling me it took them like an hour to get him out. But anyways, and this is why the staff is so special, they noticed he was really interested in other dogs. So when I said I was willing to foster, they said, oh, you know, because I have a dog, and he's a very friendly, very playful. He likes other dogs as well. And we introduced them, and the game was on. And Oliver, fortunately, has derived a lot of confidence from our dog, Zeke. You know, dogs can help other dogs. But we had some interesting things initially. We have a big room in our house, you know, with ceiling fans and windows, and it was just really overwhelming for Oliver. In fact, we got him settled down, and the cuckoo clock went off, and I thought he was going to have a heart attack. So a lot of things were hard for him, but with time, we've had him about 2.5 months. And he has settled in great. Initially, we had to put the water and food in the living room because he wouldn't walk on the kitchen floor. But he's eating in the kitchen now. His confidence has really grown. And we had a real... Labor Day weekend was amazing because he's crate trained. All of our foster dogs are, and his crate was his refuge. We had the crate in a small bedroom kind of adjacent to the living room, and he always wanted to go into the crate when things got overwhelming. And Labor Day weekend, for the first time, he slept in a dog bed in the living room. I looked up and he was curled up there just like he'd always been doing.
Yay. Yes, that's wonderful.
And I'll tell you, I know that there are a lot of people that are my age right now that are spending more time at home than I'm a person who loves to travel, and I'm not doing much traveling, as you all know. And we make great fosters. Oliver is, I would call him a medium to low energy dog. He definitely, he plays with Zeke, but he's great on the leash. He likes, you know, nice, easy, short walks. And there are a lot of dogs like that that are a little more low-key, a little more, all they really need is a quiet place. And he's happiest just to be with us. He loves my husband. I don't quite get that because I tell him my husband does nothing for you. I mean, he's had a lot of times, but he doesn't feed him. He does, you know. But Oliver still loves him. So it's really rewarding when you know that you have a dog that's having a rough time in the shelter. And there are many dogs that don't. The dog that we adopted from the shelter didn't really have a rough time there. She was really happy to have the regular meals.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Well, and there are some dogs that lived in a house all their life, so a shelter is such a shock for them to go into. So it's great that you're able to foster him like that. Has he had any interaction with children? I mean, obviously another dog, he was okay, but what about children?
He has, and I believe that because of his kind of shyness and sensitivity, they're recommending, I would imagine, maybe children like 8 or so. He's been around kids here, not a lot, because we're not having a lot of kids over like we usually do.
Oh, yeah.
But he's, as long as they're, you know, as long as they're respectful and give him some time to get to know, and it helps with our dog Zeke, because Zeke is very friendly, and Zeke is really used to children, and he follows Zeke's lead.
Gotcha.
Love to see him to go into a home that has another dog, and he's quite popular for play dates. Because he gets along, he's played with little dogs, and he can play rather gently with them. He plays with bigger dogs that are kind of rough. I mean, he has excellent dog social skills. He may be shy about, you know, other things in life, but when it comes to dogs, and that's why I'd love to see him. I mean, I don't think he has to have another dog, but I think it'd be a waste of a dog who's very social. He could probably easily go to the dog park and make friends.
If you've already got a dog and you think that you have, it would like companions, Oliver would be a good one for you.
And I say that because he's met so many dogs that, you know, we there are a couple dogs we introduced him to. We kind of put the word out with our friends. And, you know, a couple of those dogs were not the easiest dogs to play with. In fact, there was one friend who had a dog that doesn't play well with our dog Zeke because Zeke's a little too much, and Oliver was so respectful. And if the dog was a littler dog and didn't want Oliver to approach too quickly, and Oliver said, "That's okay, I'll give you some space." So he has really good instincts with other dogs.
Plays well with others is always a good good thing. Yes. Now,
as people say, I want someone to play with my dog, and Oliver, good. He's around our screen porch, and he's very interested in birds. He does a very strong play drive, but he loves to watch birds, especially if they kind of swoop and dive, and it's cute because he'll sort of lie down like, I wish they'd come over and play with me. So.
Right?
So handsome.
I know, man. That face is so cute. Now, Mary, you were telling me you've been a foster and you've been volunteering with them for, 8 years now. Tell somebody who's been thinking about becoming a foster or becoming a volunteer, what would you say to them? What, you know, why are you still doing it after 8 years? That's awesome.
Well, Chris, we adopted our dog Rue from the shelter I went to volunteer there, and of course I told my husband I wasn't going to bring any dog home, but I started in January and I brought Rue home in May. And
guilty.
We did lose
guilty.
We did lose Rue in June. She was 11, and so part of my you know, the shelter has my heart because they gave us such a wonderful dog. And then actually Zeke is a rescue from Rottweiler Hearts Rescue. He's a tripod. He's missing a front leg, and it doesn't slow him in the least. So don't feel sorry for him. Here, Oliver, I want to get your pretty face on there. I'm trying to work my Zoom. But anyways, that started me volunteering, and I love the dogs. I love working with dogs, the dogs. I love the staff. I've learned so much from our behavior manager and some of the other volunteers about handling dogs. you just, it's, and you know, the volunteers are just so happy, and they're cat volunteers too. I'm not a cat person. In fact, people will tell you there, I'm not a bit afraid of big dogs, but I'm terrified of some of those big mean cats.
I'll tell you what, with the claws, I don't blame you.
So I've enjoyed it quite a bit, and I'm not going in right now. In the past, I would have been walking dogs and training other dog volunteers, but I'm not doing that because of COVID. And of course, there are not many events going on because of COVID, but we're hoping that that'll all change. But foster was just a natural extension, especially because we're home. Zeke was a little lonely because we'd lost our dog. And the nice thing is when you fill out the application, they really match you with a dog that is the right fit. Here, Oliver.
Well, I love that. Well, Mary, I appreciate you taking the time to chat with us and bringing Oliver on. We'll make sure to put all of his info below and also information about volunteering and fostering. You're like a superstar. I love it.
Well, thank you. And I'm going to encourage my fellow more mature people out there to think about making space in your home. You won't regret it. It'll get you up off the couch and it'll do good.
Awesome. Well, Mary, thank you so much. And Molly, thank you too.
Thank you both.
Hi, Oliver.
Hi, Oliver. He's quite like, birds.
He's like, they're birds. Forget it.